for USA Olympic men's hockey coach Tony Granato.
It's the way to be in front.
The challenge of putting together a roster of non-NHL players while balancing his full-time job as the head coach at the University of Wisconsin keeps him pretty busy. But as he told us recently when we sat down with him at the Kohl Center, being a one-time Olympic player himself, now being the coach, has been the honor of a lifetime.
Yeah, I don't think it's been difficult. I'm a coach at the University of Wisconsin, so all my attention, you know, that needs to be focused on our team here has been to just that. And, you know, when I have time on weekends or Sundays or after practices to get some phone calls in and to talk to the other coaches and some of our players or potential players, you know, that's when I've been able to get that done.
You got a group of players now, finally, that you've kind of compiled, at least to look at. That process, I would assume, has been a challenge, not just for you, but the whole coaching staff when you're talking and trying to look all over the world for guys who can compete at the Olympic level.
I think the challenge part, it's interesting you say that, because it's been exciting for us.
Yeah.
Because I think right when it was announced that NHL players weren't playing, I think everybody thought, oh man, that's no good for us. But you know, I think what it does do for us is it gives us the opportunity to show our depth off and to be able to look around and see how many great players that we have playing internationally, we have playing in college, that we have playing on some minor league contracts. We got a lot of depth. We got a lot of players.
I think that's the one exciting thing for us as coaches is, yeah, obviously we don't have Patrick Kane and Ryan Suter and Joe Pavelski and Jonathan Quick, but what we have is a lot of players available to us that are extremely skilled.
In your experience in talking and in contacting some of these players, is there a different kind of excitement with these guys who probably maybe didn't have the Olympics on their radar as of a year or two ago?
Very true. I think the general response has been, you can see the emotion and the passion and the energy and the excitement of like, wow, I have a chance to be part of an Olympic team or a chance to make an Olympic team. And I think their energy and their excitement and their passion is going to be what our identity of our team will be.
Yeah.
And I think that's always the way the Americans have been. And it started with 1980 team.
I'm curious about your thoughts on the level playing field of the Olympics. I mean, obviously, every country is going to deal with this. They're going to deal with NHL players that aren't going to be there. Do you feel like it's level across the board with the way it's going to be?
I think it's going to be more competitive from the standpoint that I think the teams that usually are the 10th and 11th and 12th seeds will have chances to keep games close and chances for upsets. I think it'll be a lot more competitive that way. I think our team, with the talent we have and where we're at as a country as far as our depth and where USA Hockey's come, I think we should be very confident going in that we can compete with anybody.